Well, of course, Simon Awell has delighted the fans here at the Surrey Fort Sports Complex. Can it be a double? Because, of course, an Indian player involved in the last of our semi-final matches, Srikanth Kadambi, up against the qualifier from China, Xue Song. Now, Victor Axelsen is already through to the final. And if you look very closely at that score, let me just explain. Tommy Sugiarto won the opening game 24-22. Victor Axelsen was up in the second game when Tommy Sugiarto had to retire with a bad back. So these two will do battle for the right to meet Victor Axelsen in tomorrow's men's singles final. Well, he's had to battle all the way through the qualifying event. Two matches in the qualifying to get through to the main draw. The 21-year-old Xue Song from China. Four different nations involved at semi-final stage of the men's singles, as indeed was the case in the women's singles. So that's interesting. Xue Song has decided to start that far side of the court. So Srikanth Kadambi, the number two seed, the current world number four, in fact enjoying his seventh week at a career high of number four. His win-loss record for the year, very, very impressive. This is his fourth tournament. He's already been in two finals. He won the Swiss Grand Prix gold. That was the last tournament he played, having already reached the final of the Syed Modi Grand Prix gold in Lucknow. Had a disappointing All England, lost in the first round, despite being the number four seed, and lost out to the left-hander Kenta Momoto. But he got his revenge earlier this week here in Delhi, because in the very second round, he had to play the former world junior champion, the left-hander Kenta Momoto, once again. And as you can see, he got through in three games. Incidentally, his first two opponents, left-handers. And then in the quarter-final, well, he got revenge for last year's first round defeat here at the Indian Open, because he beat Takuma Ueda of Japan in three games. What a thrilling match that was, an hour and 18 minutes. So to Xue Song, the 21-year-old from China, former silver medalist at World Junior Championships 3 years ago. Best he's been in the world ranking is 27. He's 43 at the moment, as you can see, and that translates into being the fifth-ranked Chinese player on the world ranking at the moment. Now, as I say, he came through to qualifying matches, and then in the very first round of the main draw beat the number four seed Chao Tien Chen, who of course had won the French Super Series last autumn. And then in the second round he beat Kashyap Parupalli, who won the Commonwealth Games gold medal last year. And then in the quarter final it was a battle of qualifiers, because he was up against Guru Saidat of India. How lovely to see Guru Saidat back to full fitness. He struggled with injury, I know, that young Indian player. And although he lost yesterday's quarter-final, lovely to see him playing well again. Well, as you can see, this is the third meeting between these two players. Both their previous matches have gone the full distance. And the last time they met was in the Denmark Open last year, with Srikanth Kadambi winning on that occasion. The first time they met, of course, was in the final of the Syed Modi Grand Prix gold last year, so a little over a year ago. And we can see our umpire for this one, Fabio Betto from Italy. And let me just tell you a little bit more about
ladies and gentlemen,
final
on my right,
in luck now in January 2014, because Treshong came from again and 12-19 down to win that final. It was an extraordinary match.
Level play.
But Srikanth Kidambi, the new sensation of Indian men's badminton. Oh, that's a nervous looking shot, isn't it?
Service over. One.
Won the China Open, the premier Super Series event, Srikanth, at the end of last year. Nearly a year ago, not only losing in the first round of this India Super Series event, Srikanth, but started last year ranked 47 in the world. He finished the year ranked 4 in the world. That is an incredible climb up the world rankings. Now, I am a little concerned to see some strapping on the left calf muscle of Srikanth Kidambi. I'm really not sure. Whatever it is, there's a problem, and that is concerning. Never want to see any athlete injured. Desperately difficult, I can assure you, to play those tumble net shots off tumble net shots, and therefore when one is slightly loose, it's pounced upon. No, he does look nervous to me. I wonder if he's slightly tentative about his movement too. Gopichand on the coach's bench for Srikanth. What a difference Pulela Gopichand has made to Indian badminton in general. Whole host of world-class players now. Stayed with the shot there, Srikanth. Watch the second net shot. Yeah, no real sort of caressing of the shuttle, just almost getting his racket in the way.
Service over 5.
These little touch shots that, when you're nervous, they're so difficult to play. Song turned to play the backhand from deep in court, he knew he was in trouble. When your opponent is taking it late at the back of the court, move your base position a little further forward so you can attack any drop shot. And again. Yeah, really good pressure coming forward now from Srikanth. Line judge.
Service over 8-9.
A joy to watch when he's attacking his Srikanth Kadambi.
Service over 10-8. Oh,
that is absolutely superb attacking play. An interesting reaction from Shuai Song at the end of that rally. Rarely see players looking frustrated, but take a look at this. Yeah. Oh, Srikanth will be very happy with that, and so will his coach Pulela Gopichand. 3-point advantage at the mid-game interval.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Thank you. Our Chinese fans, I think, have been drowned out at the moment by the home fans. And the home fans are in mood to celebrate after Simon and Abel getting through to the final of the women's singles.
11, 8, play. Over 9-11.
terrific tumbling net shot.
12-9.
How on earth did he play that? He seemed to sort of chop underneath it. Oh, beautiful block. Turned 22 last month, Srikanth Kidambi, but he looks very at ease and experienced on the big stage now. Seems to have overcome the early match nerves and really settling into it now. Oh, that's nicely done.
Service over, 10-13. Clever.
A half-pace smash aimed straight at his opponent. Yeah, in fact, you can almost say it was a fast drop shot. Trying to psych himself. Well, his desire, there's no question about that, but he's trying to counteract the home fans' support for Srikanth by really trying to fire himself up even more. Maybe also show the fans that they're not intimidating him.
11-14.
Song wasn't expecting his opponent to get the first one back.
16,
that
11.
One there. Yeah, but good defense from Srikanth. brilliant play. That is super play. From Schwer Schon.
Service over 13-17.
Width of the court.
17. Play.
They are ready to bounce. Yeah, loose net shot on that occasion from Srikanth.
17.
Missed it. Oh, no, he hasn't. I thought for a moment he was going to hit that long.
16.
Well, that was well played.
17.
Yeah, well in. What on earth was I thinking? Yeah, he's done well. Four straight points, and now there's only 1 point in it. Still managed to play well. Super. Well, didn't want to lift the shuttle at all in that rally, Srikanth, because of the drift. Everything going in a downward direction, all played back to the net. Exchange. Oh, super angle. Again, sacrificing play power for the placement and the angle. Take a look at this. Goes up in the air, slices across the feathers, bringing it down steeply. Look, it's landing well in front of Schwer Schon. Well, four game point opportunities, court needing to be mopped, and therefore Schwer Schon being allowed to go and towel down. And Srikanth sending the umpire and his opponent a message by staying on court. Game point. Oh, delightful. That is super. Wonderful touch, played with disguise.
Game won by Srikanth Kidambi,
and the opening game to the number two seed, Srikanth Kidambi. Confirmation 21-16 in 20 minutes of play.
Diallo.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Second game. Level. Play.
So one game in the bag, 21-16 for Srikanth Kadambi. Now two Chinese coaches came on during that 2 minute timeout, and both were offering an awful lot of instruction. Oh, indecision, my goodness me. Think from the gesturing from the Chinese coaches, they were probably advising their man that he needed to be more aggressive in his style. Miles an hour. Song raced to a 3-love lead in the opening game. Oh, good net shot. Yeah, well played. Good look from Srikanth towards the umpire. Was that a fault? Did he take it before it crossed over the net? The umpire says no. Ooh. Goodness me, that was close. Short. Yeah. Simple put away. Control the rallies. Tight spinning net shot, forcing the short lift, and then the opportunity to play the winner. He had his eye on his opponent rather than watching the shuttle.
Service over. Five.
Not that uncommon for that to happen. Yeah. To pounce, shuttle never went over. Oh my goodness, what defense! And now from his opponent. Missed it. Well, the backhand defense early on in that rally from Srikanth, guiding the shuttle across court, and then his opponent, an equally good backhand defense. Your opponent's bound to step forward. Look, here's the backhand. In goes Srikanth. Thanks very much. Pushes from the net before he finally won the rally. Nice net exchange. Oh, that's great. Well, I think he was so determined, Srikanth, not to play the backhand and to play the round the head shot.
Thank you. Thank you.
So back level. Me too.
8-0.
Fans are definitely in the mood for a party.
Service over. 9-0.
Good use of the body smash. Yeah, the obvious shot would have been straight down the line. Just keeping his opponent guessing. We're mixing it up. Oh, look at that. Super, super net shot. And a two-point advantage here in the second game for the number two seed, Srikanth Kidambi. It wasn't even that tight, was it? Choe Song backpedaling in court, looking for the lift. Srikanth's really encroaching forward his base position. Every time he's played his opponent near the back of the court. Oh dear, that was a nice little stumble actually there from Choe Song, wasn't it? No damage done. Look, he's staying forward again. A classic demonstration of how to outmaneuver your opponent. Smash across court, deep into the forehand corner.
Thank you.
Wonderful play.
13-9.
Well, we have one at 3-9-8 in the opening game. Bounced off the top of the tape and rebounded into his own court.
13.
delight to watch when he's in this attacking mood. Srikanth. Just giving us a demonstration of why he's climbed so high on the world rankings. Srikanth. Under pressure in the early stages, didn't panic, got himself out of trouble, and then when the opportunity arose, put the shuttle away with ease. There's another wonderful winner. There's no point challenging that. That was clearly in. Ten of the last 12 points.
Service over 11-16.
Still has the courage to play the backhand. Well, there was no way that last one was coming back. Put it away with venom. Look at that defense. Expecting it to come back, but was alert enough to play the winner. Pressurizing from the front of the court. Two points away from a place in the final.
Service over. Well,
nod, but is it too little too late? Chinese coaches will need a lot of thinking after this. Chinese players in the mixed doubles final tomorrow. And the women's doubles final. And that is it so far. And this is a remarkable comeback from Shui Shong. Shui Shong was a game and 12-19 down in the final of the India Grand Prix Gold in Lucknow at the beginning of last year, and he came back to win it. to add to pessimistic fans, but the opening game was 21-16 to Srikanth in Lucknow, that final that I'm referring to. History couldn't repeat itself again, could it? Surely not. Lovely play. And up come seven match point opportunities.
Service over. 20. Match point. 30. Thank you.
Done it. What a day for Indian badminton. Prior to today, no Indian player had ever reached the final of their home Super Series event. Tomorrow, there will be two players from the host nation contesting on finals day. Both the singles finals will feature an Indian player because Srikanth Kidambi has done what Saina Nehwal did in the previous match and won his semi-final. Two straight games, 21-16, 21-13 in 42 minutes. Well, what a semi-finals day it's been. So, my goodness, mate, Molly looked awfully nervous to start with, didn't he, Srikanth Kidambi? But it's not how you start, it's how you finish. And he finished in tremendous style. Well, terrific day of badminton. It really has been. It all started with the mixed doubles and the defending champions, Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen, booking their place in the final with a victory over Praveen Jordan and Debbie Susanto. Two straight games, as you can see. Then we had the first of the women's singles and the battle of the world champions, the 2013 world champion against the current world champion. And what a match that was. That will live in my memory for a long, long time. Rachanuk coming back from 9-17 down in that opening game before she won it 21-17. Had a match point in the second game at 21-20, but lost that second game. And then a thriller of a decider. An hour and 24 minutes for Rachanuk Intanon to come through 22-20 in that deciding game. Then we had men's doubles. And for Chai Biao and Hong Wei against the European champions from Russia. Well, Chai Biao and Hong Wei will tomorrow contest a fifth Super Series tournament final. Yet to win a Super Series title, but three tough games, as you can see. Then we had the second of the women's singles semi-finals, Saina Nehwal, the Olympic bronze medalist. We know that she will be world number one come next Thursday. Today, she did the job very well in her semi-final against Yui Hashimoto, two straight games. And as we've just witnessed, well, Srikanth Kidambi has given the Indian fans an awful lot to cheer about because he will also be in the final tomorrow. Srikanth Kidambi will play against Victor Axelsen in the men's singles final. What a semi-finals day it's been. It really has been tremendous. We, of course, will be back with the finals tomorrow, same time as today. And as the fans celebrate, we leave you with some wonderful memories. It has been a great day. Join us tomorrow for the finals from all of us here in Delhi, especially me, Jill Clark. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.